Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynut and welcome back to Dark Souls 3. We're still in the demon ruins below the catacombs. Never actually thought I would say something was below the catacombs, but it's starting to look a lot like Dark Souls 1 actually. Since the demon ruins in Dark Souls 1 were also below the catacombs. You there, are you? Yeah, you can't actually stand magic. Let's not try and get hit by anything for now, because I'm down to my last Estus flask. Another big room. A bit more goat people. So let him bounce off the shield and just hack away. Anything else? You need to be careful for slimes on the where the hell did you come from? Poison mist. There goes the sorcerer. Ah, goddammit. Backstab! There, that one goes, and another Titanite shard. Well, I'm really stacking up here. Okay, is this a trap? Another Ember. Don't want to use that right now. That's where I killed the other guy. And this goes back up, probably to the other side then. Okay. Wait, that bonfire is already lit, or is that... Have I been here? Oh no, it's not lit. Never mind, so let's rest. And well, I'm gonna continue because I'm really hype. I think I backstabbed him. And I think I backstabbed him again. There we go. Goodbye. Large Titanite shard, so we can go straight ahead or back. Pincer attack ahead. Well, I got something for that. I just lured this guy over here. Because I can see that he wants me to enter the room, but... There's indeed one on the left and the right. Wow! Okay! Yeah, you can't poison a corpse, I think, but... So that was bullshit. Should have gone for the right one first. Luckily, I only get those brazen ideas when I'm really close to a bonfire, so... Let's backstab this goat fella. Okay. For some reason the attack didn't connect there. So let's do the same thing to the goat man again. And then pick the correct one this time. So the one on the right has the... the knife, and this one has the spear. There we go. And then again, we have one of those big fellows. I'm gonna take my swords first, just in case that big thingy just grabs me. It's dead. Isolith Pyromancy Tome. That's very cool. A pyromancy tome from Isolith, containing pyromancies of the witches. Give to the old master pyromancer to learn Chaos Pyromancies of Isolith. Chaos pyromancies manipulate lava and birtheth all later forms of pyromancy. So that should be a good reason to go back to pyromancy. I'm wondering if there are... Because it looks like there's a few that are lit up a bit. Not these, maybe this one? Probably not, since that just... No, that just loops around to over here on the left. It's actually really well designed, but the three branches are something that was in the demon ruins again. Too. It was in the demon ruins as well. Because the Witch of Isolith transformed into some kind of fire tree creature. That noise is not comforting. So, Crystal Lizard with a Chaos Gem. What is that? A gem-infused titanite of infused titanite. Relics of lands scorched by the Chaos Flame. Use an infusion to create Chaos Weapons. Chaos Weapons inflict fire damage and scale with intelligence and faith. So it's, fire damage such as the fire gem, but it has scaling with faith and intelligence. Which might make it a really nice weapon for me. Is there nothing we can do here? Just that Chaos Gem. Ooh, that's gonna be... That's gonna be annoying. Because these are the only ways I could go. I hear something, but... Ooh, there's a giant hole up here. Could this be a dead end? Well, it is. It looks like it. Is there a road I missed somewhere? Because this thing was a dead end, wasn't it? That was weird. But, let's head back to over here then. So wait a second, I think I came... Yeah, I came from down there, but... It does look like the only way to go right now. Except... Uh-huh. There's a lot of slimes on the ceiling here. So let's work our way through here first. Okay then. Let's drink the Ashen Flask. And continue casting. I see you over there, but I apparently cannot actually attack you. Whoa! Okay, that was a really quick attack for a tiny little slime like you. There we go. Let's keep my distance a bit. And then there's the... Oh, there's the other side of the hole. Esther Shard. Oh, yeah. Me like. Oh, yeah. Okay, never mind. That's where that ends up. I'm not interested. So, that's also kind of a dead end. Well then. Suppose I need to return back down? I never went... Oh yeah, wait, I did go this way. So there's one patrolling the area. I think I might be able to bypass it or not. God damn it. Well, I got more titanite shards for it. Flamethrower statue. There we go, there we go. Huh. I'm starting to wondering if I should be returning, because... Mm-hmm. So that's the room I came from, right? Yeah, that's the room. I've been there, I've been here as well. I don't think I've been here. They can send fireballs off to me all they want, but... Okay, now we're getting somewhere. I kicked a rat. That was awesome. So this place is different. If my character would like to attack, that would be awesome. Well, they don't do any damage. Fog wall ahead. Holy sh! That was really good, actually. I never would have hit that. Because it doesn't look like an illusory wall. This goes to more rats. Is this... Fuck me, I'm turned around. So that's where that fog wall leads as well, I think. Oh yeah, that's where we could drop down onto the big rat. But first, let me get through here and then here on the left. This place is huge. Oh yeah, and that's the other hole we couldn't jump. Oh god, is that what I think it is? This looks like Quillag's body. Or the white, or her sister's body, but I forgot her name. Quillana. What's her sister's name? Quillana? It looks like it. There's a guy sitting beneath her as well. That is awesome. So we got another pyromancy tome. Over here. A pyromancy tome of Quillana containing her unique spells. These pyromancies can only be taught by a female master. Give to a female pyromancy master to learn Quillana's pyromancies. Quillana, the sole surviving witch of Izalith, once accepted a human pupil, but after the pupil moved on, she never took another. I think we were that pupil in the first Dark Souls. Well, this looks all fun and games, but I'm not gonna enter that place, now am I? It's filled with lava. If it's the same as the demon ruins in Dark Souls 1, I'm gonna suppose I need to kill a boss before I do anything with that. So that's the hidden wall. Okay, so I can go down here. Which actually means we're going below the lava. Which is a creepy thought in its own right. So there's nothing on the ceiling, it seems, so let's... It's a rat, so it's still pretty weak, although it's gigantic. Hidden path ahead. For fuck's sake. There are more rats. There are a lot more rats. It's not a mimic. Whoa. The sound that made a creep me out. That was a basilisk sound. Not three large titanite shards. Illusory wall ahead. Holy motherfucker! That was good. That was really, really good. So we can drop down on top of the basilisks right there. This is starting to get really confusing. So I think I opened an illusory wall within an illusory wall right now. So this is where I could have dropped. Yeah, from there I could have dropped down. Anything else besides, well, there's a path down here. That's probably where the basilisks are. There's one over there. So that was actually behind me, which was great. One saw me. Okay, get over here, get over here, get over here, or dissipate. Because I don't want to get cursed. I really, really don't want to get cursed. And they're the place is full of those little buggers. So these guys were a menace in Dark Souls 1. Because they could actually, kill you just as much as they can in this game. But the deficit in getting cursed in this game is not as bad as being cursed in Dark Souls 1, in OG Dark Souls. Now there's one left. They can't really attack besides spewing that fog, so once you get close they don't stand a chance. But in Dark Souls 1, if you got cursed, you lost half your health bar. Permanently. I still hear one. There he goes. There's another staircase over there. Titanite skills. That's awesome. So I could have dropped. Oh, I still can, because there's an item over there. But I didn't want to go in the deep end of the pool. The basilisk pool. So let's loop around behind the chest. Isolate staff, that sounds right up my alley, doesn't it? Isolate staff. Well, it's already better than what I'm using. Seriously? It already is a lot better than what I'm using. Scaling is a bit less, but I can probably upgrade that. Ancient catalyst of the Witch of Isolith and her daughters, used long before the dawn of chaos and of pyromancy. With the birth of the Chaos Flame, the Flame Witches were at once both sorcerers and shamans. Fate adjusts the power of sorceries cast using this catalyst, and the staff also seems to boost the power of dark sorceries. And then the steady chant skill, as with most staffs. I'm wondering if this is a unique item and you need to upgrade it with Twinkling Titanite or Titanite Scales. Gonna have to see that once we get back to Firelink Shrine. But first, let's head to that staircase, if there aren't any basilisks anymore. The handy thing about basilisks is, of course, that they announce their presence. So we can go up, or we can go over here as well. Okay, so there's more lava down here. People seems to have... Wait a second. Holy shit! He just one-hit me. I'm not even sure if I know my way back there. I think it's over down here. I think it was. Oh, don't give me trouble with this guy.
Why the hell?
Well, that's 18,000 souls down the drain. God damn it. Seriously, let's put a one-hitting knight in the basement. And now let's kill that son of a bitch. Because I know that guy, he's one of the knights from Dark Souls 1, actually. Yeah, okay, I needed to go alongside this tree here. So he's wearing heavy armor, so let's boost the sword up. Let's go fight the fella. Damn it, I'm not even getting close for this side sweeps. Yeah, I'm dead. I can't even get a fucking hit in. Down you go, motherfucker! So a shield is absolutely useless against that guy. Fume Ultra Greatsword and a Black Iron Great Shield and a Night Slayer's Ring. Let's check all that out. So the Fume Ultra Greatsword, this twisted sword, the heaviest of all Ultra Greatswords, resembles Black Slate. This weapon, said to belong to a traitor from long ago, was so heavy that it found no owner and became a forgotten relic of history. Stomp, use one's weight to lunge forward with a low stance and increased poise, and follow with a crushing strong attack. We've seen him use that quite a few times. So then we have the Great Shield over here, of course, 100 physical. Great Shield made of black iron, deeply feared for its association with Nightslayer Tzorig. Black iron offers high defense and is particularly effective at warding off fire. And it has a shield bash. And then the ring over here, the Night Slayer's ring. Ring of the Savage Tzorig, more commonly known as the Night Slayer. Enemies lose more stamina when guarding attacks. Long ago, Tzorig engaged the guardians of an ancient city in a bloody confrontation and returned with their rings as his prize, still frozen on their dismembered fingers. So, this ring is the reason why I lost all my stamina in one hit when I blocked his attacks. And aside from that, that his attacks were fucking strong. Fine. Is there anything else here aside from this guy? Well, not really much souls in there. Well, more lava it seems. No hidden areas over here. Nope. Okay then. So let's head back up and take the other stairs. Kind of bypassed all the basilisks, so there might be a few lingering around here. Don't hear him, so they're still over there. Okay. Another knight, yeah, because we haven't fought enough of those yet. Does he have a ranged weapon? Because it looks like he's kind of waiting for me. Now I'm gonna lure you down here a bit so I can actually backstab you. And down he goes. Well, I'm getting pretty good at defeating those guys. He doesn't drop anything, apparently. And I'm still grieving for my lost souls. No. Let's kick the wall! Maybe something else will happen. So there's an item over there on the right, and then a giant ladder, apparently. Soul of a crestfallen knight. That is a big fucking ladder. That hopefully brings me up to that ballista. I hope. Because that's the reason why I went in here over an hour ago. And there's another one. The level designer said, oh god! We need another ladder. There's an item over there. Might as well grab that first. Mine! Dragon Rider bow. Awesome. Longbow of the Dragon Riders who served the old King of Wan from Dark Souls 2. The Dragon Riders were the old King's loyal guard, and great strength was demanded of them. Merely drawing this bow calls for inhuman strength. The worthy few who can master this bow, however, use it to devastating effect. Puncture. So as if... Oh, I need one more strength to wield it, and it's more strength-based than dexterity-based. Interesting. So drop down on the right here, and then take the ladder back up. I was talking about the old king. So that's talking either about Vendrick or the old Iron King, which would be fitting with all the lava around here. Oh yeah, now we're at the ballista. We are at the ballista. It's rotating. It won't be able to hit me over here. But there are a few pinwheels over there. Ah, I thought I was behind the wall. Oh, okay, never mind, it breaks those walls. So those walls don't offer protection at all. I'm safe here, right? Homeward bones, yeah. Yeah. That would be nice, but... I do want to finish this episode off with taking down the ballista for good. I've seen a lot of pinwheels over here. So if I lure them in one by one, I got souls, so I'm gonna presume he's not gonna come back. So that's another one down. That's the last one, I think. Yeah, I got souls. I got souls! So... seems to be another route up there. But I'm gonna have to fight a few more skeletons before that's over. What are they looking at? Is he mad at me? He looks mad at me. You gonna hit me, bro? Where's he going? Sometimes it looks like he forgot where we needed to go. Need to be careful with skeletons since they can parry you. Is that gonna rotate this way? I'm not seeing. I only want one of those. Yeah, I remember you. Okay, quick side note, I'm gonna use the fucking talisman. Talisman. Because, well, now that I got here, I don't want to die. So there's only one of those left. Could use soul arrows to take him down. He dropped an item. Titanite shards and yellow bug pellets. Dancing between the pinwheels. Yes, I'm stalling a bit so that I'm healed all the way up. If he's walking back, might be able to get a few soul arrows in. So just a few more seconds before I... I might as well go to the equipment screen already to remove it. Should be enough. Yeah, okay. Block that, but okay. Okay. I'm gonna remove the bow for a second and just equip that chime, because I'm gonna need it. There we go. Because I'm all out of Estus. So, let there be tears. That's... do it. I can push the lever. There are a few giant corpses over there. Let's push it then. Did I just turn it off, or maybe the Let There Be Tears is for these giants, although they are a bit smaller than the ones we've seen before in the cathedral. So does that mean that I actually shut it down? Because it looks like it. It also looks like I can drop down. And I do not know why I would want to do that. Because it will land me smack in the middle of those crabs. Well, I did what I set out to do. We got all the way through to this contraption. Raise the lever, yeah, indeed. Hopefully the next time I die this thing just doesn't restart, but well, I'm guessing it's time for me to head down there then, towards that boss fog. That's gonna be for next episode, so I'll probably head back to the bonfire and warp back to the entrance. So, but without further ado, I'm gonna take a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. I hope you enjoyed the episode, and if you did, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I really appreciate the support. You don't know how happy that makes me when I see someone subscribe. So thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video stream. Goodbye!